Hello everyone and welcome. Today we're going to take a look at a very special high security cylinder, the StealthKey, made by UrbanAlps, a company based in Switzerland, Zurich to be exact, and their motto is smart, simple, seriously secure. And just as the stealth bomber or the stealth fighter, who are both different, way different than other planes, this lock is also different than other locks. So, let's turn it around and take a look at it. The presentation model of the cylinder comes in a really cool IP67 certified case. And let's open it up and take a look inside. When opening it up, you will recognize an advertisement banner at the top telling you that the StealthKey cylinder has won a Golden Innovation Prize at the Security Fair in Essen 2018. That they have a worldwide patent for the StealthKey cylinder, and that they will give you a 10-year warranty on the cylinder. Other than that, you will also find the cylinder itself on the left, the key in the middle, and the security card on the right. So let's take a look at the Europrofile cylinder of the StealthKey lock. First, you recognize, okay, it doesn't really look different than other high security cylinders such as a Kaba or a Kiso. The StealthKey cylinder is also adjustable in length. A locksmith can buy an extension kit to do that. You will have to remove these pins down here, and then you can take the cylinder apart, remove this hardened steel rod down here, and adjust the length of the cylinder. We also have these really big and chunky hardened steel rods down here for drill protection. We have the system number laser engraved on this side and the quality control pass sticker on the other side. But taking a look at the front, you recognize the laser engraved Stealth logo here, but also the keyway. Take a look at the keyway. It really looks intriguing. So let's take a look at the security card next, which is also a bit different from other security cards I've seen before. We've got the company logo up here, your system number here, and an additional field for group number if your cylinder is part of a specific group within a system, and we've got a hidden code field down here. And this is actually your key code, which is needed by your authorized dealer to cut new keys for your specific lock, so to speak, your key ID. And if you want to buy new keys for your cylinder, you need to uncover that code and then give this card to your authorized dealer, and then he will be allowed to cut new keys for your specific StealthKey lock. So if you one day come home and you find the key code of your cylinder being uncovered on your security card, then you will know, okay, someone might have used my security card to cut new keys for my lock. But if the code is still covered, you're still safe and everything's cool. On the back, we've got the address of the company, and this card is for registration and administration of your data and for ordering additional keys. So far for the security card. Last but not least, the prime factor, which makes this lock so much different from other locks, the key. Taking a look at the key, you will notice, oh, this looks much different than other keys. It looks like key blank, like it hasn't been cut before. I'm turning it around. Well, we find some laser engravings, like there's a patent pending, system ID, your specific key number or copy number, this is key number 01, and your key ID or your code number. In my case, it's a very simple code number because this is a sample cylinder, but there is no key profile, no cuts, and the key also feels different, different material, like it hasn't been cut, or like acts a bit different. The thing here is the actual key profile is hidden within this key. It's hidden beneath here or in here. And this key can't be cut. This is a key which gets printed and not cut. And I'll explain a little bit more in the next part. Taking a look at traditional keys, like this size icon key, for example, we'll have a key profile with certain depths, and your locksmith can buy key blanks for this size icon lock and then use your key code to cut new keys for you. And in some cases, when we have high security cylinders like this multi-lock, we'll have an active element within the key, which makes it very difficult to make a quick cast of this key, for example, because we have that active element within the key. But for example, an authorized locksmith or dealer, he can still get key blanks for this one without a problem. With the stealth key, however, we don't have that profile. We can't simply make a quick cast of this key. Or let's say a bad person can't make a quick cast of this key, and he also can't make a picture of that key. I mean, he can make a picture of your key, but it won't bring him any good because there's no profile that he can see on that key. And taking a look at the brochure from StealthKey, we will see what's different here. So down here we've got the key. And up here, because I don't have a cutaway, but here we can see, okay, there is the profile within the key, which we can't see. And this is the thing that makes this cylinder more secure than others, because the keys from the stealth key are made with industrial 3D metal printing. And that's really cool. So your key actually gets printed with an industrial 3D metal printer. Like a 3D printer for keys, but a metal printing machine. Okay, let's say you need a new key for your stealth key cylinder. You uncover the key code on your security card, you send it in, and you tell the guys at UrbanAlps, okay, I need, for example, two new keys for my mother and my grandma, for example. And they won't cut your key out of a key blank then. They will actually produce your key by laser melting layers of super alloy powder. It is the same technology that is used for producing gas turbines, for example. Or that is also used to produce rocket engines in the SpaceX program. They use the exact same material to print your key for your stealth key cylinder, which is actually pretty cool. Taking another look at StealthKey's brochure, we will find a picture where we can take a closer look within the cylinder. We will find the profile discs up here, or profile sliders, which will then interact with the hidden profile within your stealth key key. And once the right alignment is reached, there is a sidebar which can then fall into place, and you will be able to turn the key, or let's say to move the inner core or to turn it around and then unlock your door. At last, some technical information. The StealthKey cylinder is certified according to DIN EN 1303, 1630 and 1627, which is the RC class certification for protective elements. An RC 2 or 3 rated door or window, for example. The more suitable DIN EN 18252 certification for profile cylinders and door locks is on the way, as well as other certifications such as VDS certifications or the SKG 3 stars certification. Locksmiths can get extension kits for their StealthKey cylinders, and the cylinder is also available with an emergency function. Also, they have the possibility to get their own company logo here on the top section of the key. The question now is, do I like the approach of UrbanAlps with their StealthKey cylinder? And the answer clearly is yes, I do like their approach. Because in the past 20 to 30 years that I've been into collecting locks, I haven't seen anything special or anything new. Yes, manufacturers have introduced electronic security solutions a lot, and there are also many electromechanical cylinders around, but there hasn't been anything, let's say, groundbreaking or new. And StealthKey, with their totally different approach of making keys instead of cutting keys, is something completely different. And the mere fact that now you have a key that looks like a key blank, but you have a profile hidden within the key, it reminds me a little bit of the FR3KS, but with a hidden key profile. And just imagine if StealthKey would in the future also introduce an electronical part to their cylinder with an electronical, let's say, MIFAR DustFire chip, for example, at the top of their key. That would be really most awesome. And so I like it a lot, and they're going different ways than other companies, and I wish them the best of luck, and I hope you enjoyed this video, and please, in these times, stay healthy and have a good day. Bye.